All set?
Yep.
Good evening. Welcome to the Board of Selectmen meeting of October 5th. We'll start the meeting with Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay. So we're having a change of date meeting today. This substitutes our meeting for next week, and it helps us get a little further ahead in our budget process, and it also helps us go through our truck process and gives me the 12th off to enjoy my day. So with that, we'll go over the items for consent. We have September 28th minutes. We have accounts payable manifest of $111,914.38, and we have a payroll manifest of $50,182.02. Do we have any items that anybody wishes to remove?
Mr. Chairman, I'll move that we approve the consent agenda.
I have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Hearing none, we'll call this to a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? All those abstain. Motion carries. Now we have a request for additional items and other business. Does anybody have any other business? I would like to have a discussion about planning board coverage.
Oh, so, and I would like to ask for conservation coverage for Thursday night, please.
I'd like to ask for budget committee coverage.
If that's already on the agenda.
I figured I may as well chime in.
Yeah, we already have that. All right, so if there's nothing else, we'll move on to the agenda. Just as a note, public input will occur no earlier than 6:30. So with that said, I would like to shuffle this agenda slightly, and we're going to start with old business instead of the new business so that we can talk to Jack about the repair and or replacement of the F-350. How are we doing?
Well, you should have got them all on your computers. Three different prices.
Mm-hmm.
MHQ and Leonard Dairy.
Hey, Jack. Jack. Just so that all our fine folks at home can hear what we're talking about.
Here we go. Leonard Dairy Ford was... for the 350, it was $29,372. The quote from the Chevy dealer was $31,532, and that was for a
Silverado
2500 series.
Okay.
And the other was MHQ, which was 35,660. I had the plow included in that price, so it's down. What were we saying, 29 something?
29,120 was the truck.
Ooh. So the lowest bid we have is Londonderry, right? By four.
Low bid is 35,607 Londonderry Ford. That includes the plow attachment, which would be provided by Donovan.
Right.
Plow.
Wow, but it's within $53.
Right.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, go right ahead.
So when I look at these quotes, Jack, you got 250 and 350. What would benefit you? Would the 350 benefit you more than the 250 would benefit you more?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, a little heavier frame. And I did that purposely, so we'd have something to compare to.
Okay.
I think there's only like $300 or $400 difference between them, if I remember correctly.
Right. Yeah, you're looking at $29,372 for a 350,
mm-hmm.
and then $29,140 for the 250. So.
That's not even a tough decision there.
That's a 15 though, right? 2015.
Yeah, they're all 15s. So I made them quote them all at 15.
And they can get them?
Hmm?
They can get a 2015 now?
Yep. Some of these, Londonderry has it in stock.
Oh, okay.
MHQ may have to go out for it. Cork Chevrolet has it in stock, the 3500 series. But it's a lot more money.
Is there any benefit to getting a Chevy?
No, I think their 35 is the same as the 350, is what they told me. I've seen it. I mean, I actually went up over the weekend. I stopped by on Friday, looked at it. Nothing spectacular.
Would it...
Correct me. Okay, go ahead.
Sorry, Steve.
Nope, go ahead, Kevin.
With the 350 for the 29372, and when you go down the one that was quoted with the plow, is the plow route, would the plow roughly be the same price?
Everyone we have talked to about plows has been within $50.
Okay, so it's roughly, okay.
Yeah. Am I right? They're all right around.
Yeah, but I think the plow that Donovan quoted was a little bit better spec.
It's a little better quality than the one at Donovan, but it's not a heck of a lot more money. I think it's even with what we were getting from the other dealers.
Their price is actually cheaper than MHQ on the plow.
Yeah, right.
But here's my question. Is Londonderry Ford's 29372 for the 350, 29140 for the 2?
Right.
MHQ quoted the 350. And when you subtract the plow, it's 29120. It's actually a couple hundred bucks cheaper at MHQ.
Right.
For the truck.
Right. That plow price is the same as HQ.
Right. The plow
if you were to buy one from them, but you have to, they have boss. Is it boss? Not boss.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, Londonderry. Yeah, Londonderry, it's boss. Yeah.
Yeah. Londonderry is boss. It's actually a little less than a Fisher. I prefer I wouldn't buy a Fisher other than a Fisher. We get a long time out of those Fishers.
Yeah, but with that said, we could just send the truck to Donovan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, just because you said Londonderry was cheaper, it's not. MHQ is cheaper for the 350. Because it's 29120 for the 350 at MHQ.
Oh, yeah, you gotta take the two. Okay, so what's the difference?
$200.
So
okay. It's not a ton of money. I'm just making sure that we're all understanding.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying. I think I lean towards Londonderry only because of. We deal with them all the time. We take them, our trucks there for service now.
Mm-hmm.
We have one that goes to service as it is now.
Mm-hmm. Now, Londonderry's quote doesn't list out the options that MHQ's does. Is there any difference between
There's no difference between. I did check on that today.
Okay.
So they're actually the same.
So,
sorry.
Your turn. Brent, go.
The MHQ, if you get a vehicle from MHQ, warranty items, Jack, could they be handled at?
They could be handled at Ford,
Would they handle it at Ford or Londonderry, or would you have to bring it back to MHQ?
No, we do that today. So all the cruisers go to Londonderry, even though they're bought MHQ, so.
Okay, because that...
Yeah, we do service.
Anything related to the fit up, anything that was customed by them, their wiring, they would want to handle.
This truck is not available until they order it.
At MHQ. Okay.
So he told me that, what's his name? Mike Curtin, that he didn't know when we'd get it. I said, listen, I just need the price at this point. And we'll cross those bridges when we get to it.
Well, when he said you didn't know when you'd get it, he can't order it from the factory.
No, he'd have to find it somewhere in their array of dealers that they deal with. I mean, they're not a Ford dealer. They're just a municipality
they're like
dealer.
A clearinghouse.
Yeah.
For the state bid.
Right.
Right.
So the price from Londonderry, that is a 4x4, correct?
Those are all four-wheel drives, yep.
All right, so I guess the real question comes down to this. Buying the truck, buying the plow. Buying the plow separate from Donovan obviously couldn't be rolled into a payment and or a lease. It would be a separate purchase.
I don't know.
No, you can roll that.
You can roll it in.
Part of the truck.
Part of the truck.
Yeah, Ford would send it over.
It's like if you buy a chassis and you get a bid.
But it's two different places. So how would you can finance it?
We'll finance it.
The bank would do that?
Right. Finance the amount, not the vendor.
We did that with White Truck because I bought a chassis with the White Truck, and I bought a body from Donovan because we wanted the sides to flip down.
Right.
And
I believe several years ago at the fire department, we got a rescue tool, separately rolled it in to a lease with the...
it's a municipal lease.
It's a municipal leasing on the amount.
Okay.
Right.
That's what I wanted to make sure of.
Mm-hmm.
So why are they saying on the MHQ that it's a 4x2?
It's listed in the options as four-wheel drive. The 3595.
Yeah, if you went into options, it says four-wheel drive.
Yeah.
The auction is in three weeks, I was told today. If the blue truck was to go to auction, if you were to choose to buy a new one, not fix that, it would go to auction. It's just a verbal telling them that the engine had failed. That's all we need to tell them.
Yep.
And we would, it would go up there with, like, the other one. Were you on the board when we sold the other one, the blue one?
Might have been just before.
Took that up, and that went for a pretty good buck. We got about $10,000 for that truck.
The old blue.
Well, it kind of been given an idea of what that truck would be worth.
It wasn't worth much. We couldn't even get it. Nobody would take it as a trade.
In 1980,
when that blue truck goes to the auction, it's gonna be over $8,000 probably, if the plow's on it.
It will come back to the town as
exactly.
Yeah. Yep.
You got $10,000 for old blue?
I got more than that.
We pay.
Oh no, you're thinking of blue the tractor, the old Mac? No.
Yeah. Oh.
We crushed that in the yard.
You crushed it.
I was going to say, holy, I had a million miles on it in 1980.
The old 550.
It was an old Holmes transportation.
Yeah, the old 550. We got $10,000 for the old 550.
Oh, God.
Blew a rod right at the corner of Albuquerque and Pinecrest.
I remember that.
Okay.
And oil all
over. Not
When she was done, she was done.
Oh, yeah.
She was definitely done.
All right, so anybody have any more questions about this? So the purchase would come out of Londonderry, and then it would go up to Donovan.
Yep.
And Donovan would put the plow on it.
Yep.
And you'd probably have the truck within a week, right?
Couple of weeks, yeah. I'm sure Donovan's busy.
Donovan right now is right out straight. They've got big plow trucks over there, but yeah, I would say a week and a half, 2 weeks. No more than that. But we need to get that other truck. I need authorization to take the older truck. Once I strip it, I got to take the lights off, I got to take the radio out, stuff like that has to come out, and we'll get the new truck, we'll install that in that truck.
Okay. So you need a...
just an authorization, which I can get from Troy. Last one we saw, Karen wrote it up. I think the chairman signed it at that time.
So we just make a motion to get rid of it, I guess, or authorize the...
Yeah, so we need to have two motions, basically. Anybody have anything else to add? Questions? Anything of the such? Now, Donovan doesn't quote a steel cutting edge.
It comes on it.
It comes on it, then?
Yeah. They don't charge extra for
nice
cutting edges.
No, they do good work up there.
I actually kind of surprised me to see that on there, cutting edge.
Yeah, yeah.
Usually they come through on a plow.
Yeah.
That's $245.
So you're straying away from doing the flat body?
I am. I told John, I was talking to John the other day, and I just feel that it would be great to do, but at this point, with finances being the way they are, we can get by without it.
You're using a truck now, you can use a truck then, and...
Right, exactly. It was to mount the generator, you know, what we do now that we never did before. Used to go out and hacksaw the bolt off the back, because you always bend the bolt over when you put a new sign up, so the kids can't steal it. Well, we used to go out and hacksaw them off by hand. Now, we take the grinding wheel and the generator, and we go out and we cut the backs off. It takes about 2 minutes, put the new sign up, blah, 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 we're on our way. So you save a lot of time by having those kind of things. And that was what I was going to do, was set up the generator. It was given to me by the fire department. They had no use for it. We got it, so it's running really good, and mounting that on the truck, and then having the boxes, you know, and maybe getting, I have a small compressor I'd be happy to put on that truck for nothing, you know, just so that if you lose air in a tire when the trucks are out at night, or you want to use an air tool, you can do that. You ever try to do a plow breakdown at night at 3 a.m. when it's snowing? It's no fun with hand tools, let me tell you. And, you know, we are in a situation with tools because Les and I have always brought our own in. Well, Les is gone now. He only comes in whenever I need him.
Yeah.
And he took all his tools home. So all that's left is what I have in there and what the town had bought over the years, which is not a lot. So as the years progress, we're going to have to...
You're going to need some money for tools.
You're going to have to start putting some money in for tools. At this moment, you don't need to because my tools are there.
You should probably start coming up with a list for us so that we'd have an idea of what's going to
be. You have a complete inventory of what the town owns somewhere.
Yeah, it's, it should be in the capital stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what we need to go along with that as well.
Yeah, right, exactly, yeah. Not I mean, that, we have not, bought not sockets that, and stuff like
that. Not that you need
like
more
that.
To do, but.
Yeah, that's all right, no problem. So you guys know what you're going to do? Or?
All right, so I'm looking at this as $29,372 is the truck from Londonderry Ford. $62,35 is the plow from Donovan. My total is $35,607.
Mm-hmm. All right.
That sound right to everybody?
$35,607, yep.
Sounds right to me.
So how are we going to purchase this? It's going to do it through a lease?
How do we purchase it?
I mean, I know MHQ handles all that. How does it go when we're not with MHQ?
Londonderry does.
Londonderry will handle it all?
Yeah.
Yep.
I had a payment one time. I think I gave that to you, didn't I? Did I give you that?
No.
But I had that.
But did it include the plow?
No.
Uh-huh.
I don't think it did.
Because you had the utility boning and stuff.
Sure, are you all set with
the Yeah, if you authorize the purchase and if the, you know, preferred financing is lease purchase, then Jack and I will work with Londonderry Ford to get that in place.
And then come back for us as to
It will probably come back to you for
It has to come back for us
for additional signage and approval, but
So you're comfortable with everything?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll make a motion that we approve the amount of 35.6
not less than 36 is what I'd say.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we approve not less than $36,000 for the purchase, not more than
$36,000. My bad.
I'm using your word. I make the motion.
The finance is through Municipal Finance Department, which is Ford.
Mm-hmm.
So Ford has its own municipal finance. I did not get a quote.
All right, so I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
I haven't finished my motion.
All right, though. Finish your motion.
I make a motion that we authorize the purchase of a F-350 and associated plow, not to exceed the amount of $36,000.
I have a motion. Do I have a second? A motion by Mr. Brunel, second by Mr. Bork. Any discussion on the motion?
The only thing I would suggest is that we authorize the town administrator to go negotiate a
this purchase agreement.
So I'll amend the motion to say that we also authorize the town administrator to negotiate a lease purchase.
I'll second that.
Bring that back to the board.
Second.
Okay, so I have an amendment to the motion from Mr. Byron and a second to that amendment from Mr. Brunel. So we will have, is there any discussion on the amendment? Hearing none. All those in favor of the amendment, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, all those abstain. The amendment carries 500. Now we have an amended main motion. Any discussion about the amended main motion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, all those abstain. Motion carries 500. The amended motion carries. So you now have authorization to go forward with Troy and get your truck.
Okay.
Okay. So now we need to give you authorization to...
take the other truck to auction. And it's kind of how you would phrase it, I think. For me to... the authorize me to dispose of the truck at the DOT auction at White Farm.
Okay.
And how will the proceeds be?
They automatically send the check to the town. That's all they did last time.
It's like in the general fund. It can't be...
it's just going to come in as unanticipated revenue.
Yeah, it's going to come as an unanticipated revenue.
Okay.
It is the best way. It's unfortunate. It'd be so much better if they could do the trade-in, but you're going to get half the money if you tried to trade
that.
Don't
take it as a trade, I asked.
And I understand.
I tried.
Yeah, I'm okay.
It's, why would I want that?
That's what they always
say. The only
way
you'd be able to get a credit would be if Londonderry Ford would actually give you a trade-in allowance for the pickup truck. And you wouldn't have to, I don't know if they'd even be interested.
He already told me no. Yeah. It's municipal pricing that we have right now, so they're not looking to take anything in trade.
Mr. Chairman, I'll move to authorize the road agent and the town administrator to dispose of the truck in the most expeditious manner and one that will benefit the town the most financially.
Second.
I have a motion from Mr. Lemire, second from Mr. Brunel. Any discussion on that motion?
Do you want to clarify it's going to auction?
I don't feel the need. I just, the most expeditious manner and the one that will bring the most revenue to the town. If you're more comfortable with that, I don't care, but...
Jack said it's going to auction.
It's going to the state auction. It's where it's going, period. I don't know how else to phrase that, but it's the only place it can go.
Frank, is there any further desire, or...?
No.
Okay.
Everyone's happy.
Okay, so... with that being said, no further discussion. We'll call it to a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 All those opposed, all those abstain. Motion carries 500. Jack, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully, would you take the truck until you can even get it up to Donovan?
I gotta get it stripped down before I can take it up there.
No, the new one.
Oh, the new one?
If you can get the new one.
I gotta call him tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'll put him on. Sick him on him.
Yep.
If he's not out painting.
Oh yeah, you might actually have to wait for us to sign the final docs before they turn it over to you anyway.
He volunteered to paint the stripes on Hillcrest today. If I could get him a roller.
I just want to keep the cars trying to hit me, that's all.
Doesn't work.
It doesn't He's work. Wearing that shirt. He's got a good shot of being seen.
Well, thank you guys for...
Thank you very much.
I appreciate it.
Have a good one, Jack.
Here.
All right.
In touch tomorrow, Joyce.
Okay. In the morning, I'm out. I'm over in Brookline, so I'll be back in the afternoon.
All right. Thank you.
So.
Patiently over there. Dave's in the corner.
So we're now back to new business. So our new business is going to go into budget review. So in our budget review, we're going to start with, we'll start with Dave. How's it going, Dave?
Good, very good, thank you.
So, for those that don't know, Dave is our solid waste leader.
Who doesn't know that?
Only people that don't go down there. So, once I get this open.
Okay, saw Big Jim the other day.
Yeah. Seems to be doing all right.
Mm-hmm. I heard the story. Good, he's doing well, though.
I'm trying. Trying to get there. It's taking a little while.
So this morning, spent a couple hours down at the solid waste facility with Dave, gave me the tour. Very impressed with the facility. Really good job that his employees and staff are doing. It's probably one of the best facilities I've seen, working in different municipalities, so something to be proud of.
Thank you.
Dave has always taken great care of us.
Yes, he has.
Yeah. He runs a great facility. We're lucky to have him. All right, so we're in the solid waste budget now. Has everybody got it up, or was I just the last one to do it here?
Yep.
All right. So basically the only changes we have this year is we have changes to the wages, which was from the salary increases that we did through the town. Slight change in the health insurance because we are budgeting a little cushion for that, for the increase. Electricity's up about $1,000. Is that just the run rates, Dave?
That's a run rate.
Can I ask questions as we're going along?
Yeah.
So on the wages for staff, it says assistant manager 24 hours per week at whatever, 19 whatever. But the other items here, the 7,000, 6,000, 22, and 16 and all that stuff for the laborers are not shown as part of the 2015 budget, or are they?
They were all lumped together down the bottom.
Right, so we broke them out, but for more money, much more money. How come? Because that budget line goes up 18,000. And that's what I'm trying to understand.
Well, the 18,000 is probably the increase in the wages.
It was my understanding, Frank, that there were some fairly substantial wage increases to everyone at the solid waste division.
Yep.
I think that was the reason that from this point forward, they were breaking out the hours per those employees so we could track it going forward.
Okay, but last year we had 33. This year we got, 22, 16 is 38.
52,260 is a total.
So I'm just trying to understand, I mean, is it all wages or is it any changes in the organization?
Yeah, is there any increased hours down there, Dave?
No, there's no increased hours. We tried to stay right under the hours given.
I see where Frank's coming now is because the laborer at 28 hours at 1082, the laborer at 30 hours at 1169 for the 2015 budget is 58 hours. But the laborer is broken down for the 16 budget is 8, 30, and 22, which is 46 and 22 is 68.
Right.
Which is 10 hours more.
Right. Well, they had an 8-hour laborer, it looks like.
Yeah, we did when Jim left. I think that's what happened when Jim left.
They've always been short in labor for part-time.
And it's a sad.
Yeah, didn't you have several vacancies last year, too?
Yeah, people come and go. And
well, I'm not worried about that. I'm just trying to understand why the change in the value of the account, that's all.
Well, I'm breaking. I think it's in the hours. Yeah. I think that it's a combination of the raises and an increase of an extra part-timer at 8 hours.
Right.
Well, does that work for you, Frank, or do you?
The what's the hourly rate for the 30 hours? That seems like that's where the bigger jump is. That's a $3,000 jump.
Right.
$4,000 jump.
That was a pretty close to a $5 an hour increase.
That's what I thought. I know there was one big jump, and there was actually a couple of big jumps in his department.
Oh, I know that there was a couple of big ones.
So, Because I'm assuming the 31 is Little Dave, right?
No, Little Dave would be...
Oh, he's the assistant, right?
Right. Yeah. That would have been Brian.
Okay.
And he had a major jump.
Right.
Yeah, well, he's got the CDL license to go on top of it, right?
No.
But he's all certified now.
Yeah, they're all certified.
Well, we're not needing a CDL license down there.
No.
It was part of the whole what got him into the class and grade, because he works, I guess, over with Jack too.
Well, yeah, he did.
Yeah,
but that should come out of Jack's budget, not Dave's.
I wouldn't confuse that.
I was just trying to explain it, because when Jason was telling us, I personally questioned the increase, because he was receiving one of the highest increases going.
Mm-hmm.
And it was because of the feasibility and the flexibility that he gave us also over in the highway department that justified his class and grade.
Mm-hmm.
That was why. I questioned it when we were doing the raises.
Yes, you did, I remember.
I think we should keep the budget separate, that's all.
Well, I don't think it's...
It is, but it gives him a higher grade because of the experience and the level of help he gives over there as well. So his overall pay was higher because of the flexibility.
But the 30 hours that are being budgeted here is the hours he works at the recycling center, not in the highway.
Exactly.
Right. And it shouldn't affect what he's getting at the recycling center. It should only affect what he's getting at the...
No, because he's a town employee.
They're two separate jobs.
Well, that was the way it was explained to me when I asked.
Okay.
He's the one that's been there the longest, besides you and Dave. Right. Yeah.
It's a great worker, too.
Sure is.
Very good worker. Very
polite. He's been doing all the things around town, so
yeah.
That's not...
I don't know. Otherwise, how's the wages look, Frank?
Well, as I said, they look high, but that's fine.
Okay, so health insurance, dental insurance, those were the increases that we're budgeting for. The electricity was the run rates are higher. Propane is no change. Building repair and maintenance is down a couple of bucks. Dues are up a little bit, but we can't control that.
Just to make sure everyone understands, those are dues for operator's licenses, as well as the recovery association, so we can get the higher rates for our recyclables.
Correct.
Yep.
And also the hazmat collection over in Nashua that we're part of.
Okay. Diesel fuel is lower by 450. Demolition materials is lower by 1,200. Is that just changing costs, or changing the way you do it?
That's a run rate I did for the first 6 months of this year and the last 6 months of last year. When I did the budget, it was back in July, at the end of July, when we did it with Jason.
Yep.
So that's how I formulated that.
Cool.
It's the last 6 months, and I did the same with the MSW to come up with those figures on that. The same.
How are you tracking for the latter half of the 6 months? So now we're into, what, 10, right?
We're into 10. I haven't received information on 10 yet, only 9. So I can, as I did last year, I kept updating that with Jason for the budget to see if there'd be any shift in those line items towards the end of the year to make it a little bit more accurate.
Yep.
Dave, line 694, solid waste disposal, were your increases due in haulage, the number of haulage, or the number of tons, or did the rates go up?
Well, we have a 3% increase
in the rates
every year.
Right.
Now, that is reflected in the price for next year already.
Sure, but I mean, so you're basing on the same number of hauls as this year, the same number of tonnage?
I'm basing it on the averages I've received for the first 6 months, and hauls and tonnage. And the average I received last
year. Okay, so both of those went up a little bit. Both your average and
the haul
and the rates. Right?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah.
All right. Thank
you. On the MSW it did. On the C&D it went down slightly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yep, it's a 3% increase every year from Waste Management on our service contract.
So that line had an $8,900 increase?
Right.
The recyclables stay the same. Equipment lease is dropping $7,561. But that, not to get off topic, is something we're going to have to now account for in the road agent's budget.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to need to make a change on that budget. Mileage and tolls the same. Any questions, comments from the board?
Yep.
Go ahead.
Question for you on sharps.
Yep.
You've got all the stuff you need for sharps. Do you need any other safety equipment for them?
We seem to be doing well with that. No, I think we have everything. But I thank you for the concern. We have the proper signage.
You got the boxes and stuff.
We got the boxes. We got the proper signage and everything that we can do. We do find them occasionally mixed in with the plastic, but not recently. So.
Anything else from anyone? Do I have a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I'll move $366,798 for account 4321.10, Solid Waste Administration.
Second.
I have a motion from Mr. Lemire, second by Mr. Brunel. Any discussion? Hearing none, calls to a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those oppose? All those abstain? Motion carries 500. Dave, thank you very much for coming in. Thank you for the great job you're doing. Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Tell the guys down there, I say the same to them.
I will. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Dave.
Thanks, Dave.
I did it again. So what's our next budget?
I got it. Revenue, I was just doing the same thing. Revenues, personnel.
Let's go with revenue.
On insurance.
Parks. Revenue.
So revenue.
All right, I'm actually gonna break from this for one quick second, and I'm gonna open up the floor to public input. If there's anybody in the public that would like to speak, please speak now.
You wanna get up and go?
Hearing none, I will close public input at 6:39. Now on to revenues. Okay. Troy, you want to lead us through this one?
I'll try. Revenues are still one of those things that are, at this point in the budget, still sort of difficult to project. But obviously, as we get closer to December, we'll know pretty much the exact figures. I don't know if you want to go through these as we see changes, or I can go right through line number. Timber tax, we have no projection of a change. The land use change tax, recommending that we keep it at $17,000. Payment in lieu of taxes, the town of Hudson. Set at $31,000. Excavation tax at $1,600, same as last year, no change. Interest and penalties on delinquent taxes, still budgeting the same as last year, $32,574.
All right, so I'm going to ask this one. This would probably be better if Terry could answer it, but the property tax interest, are we not much better off than we've been in the past as far as delinquencies?
I can't answer that right now. We went through this with Terry today and
okay.
So we were looking at really no change.
Okay.
So but I can ask her that if our collection rate's better.
I just for some reason I feel like we've been doing really well lately, even with the ones that have been falling behind. So that was the only reason why I asked.
One thing I do have a question on, Mr. Chairman.
Yep.
Is building permits. And I'm not certain off the top of my head when the last time we looked at those was, but I'm wondering whether they should be adjusted.
At the building department, you're saying?
You mean the rates?
You're discussing the fees?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, we just did the fee review.
Which would adjust the revenues, okay. That's all I'm suggesting.
Yeah. I was just going to say, because we went through that today, and we adjusted them upward a bit based on activity, but fees, is a different discussion.
The fees you didn't touch, because the board would have to adjust that. But what I'm talking about is the fees, and I'm not saying that we have to enter it into here. I'm kind of bringing it up as maybe a placeholder that the board at some point in the future may want to look at, that's all. Because I believe that we ought to be considering, whether it makes sense or not, I don't know, but considering that it should be a zero-sum game for having a building inspector for the permits that he's doing.
Didn't we just do the fees like last year, the year before?
Like I said, I don't recollect.
I thought it was a couple of years ago.
I just remember going through it and struggling on
that. It's definitely worth looking into.
Yeah. We did at some point in the recent past look at the recycling fees for things like propane and stuff like that, and we made a decision
going through building fees in a while.
But I don't think we've gone through building fees.
I wonder if it was last time I was on the board.
I think you might be right, because I don't remember.
You were gone only for like a year.
2 years.
Was it 2 years?
Yep.
It happens 2 years of your life, right?
And I've actually been back for over a year already. So it's actually likely that it's been 4 or 5 years.
So I don't think it's because we did it with Jason, so it was within the last 5 anyway. Definitely. But yeah.
We're going to put that down as a need to be reviewed.
It shouldn't change, or I don't think we should let it impact what's here, but I'm just...
No, I agree. Okay, right. So Troy, we got a little off the beaten path.
That's fine. Really, the next big item is the motor vehicle permit fees. And this one here, I'm just, with the economy the way it is, everything seems to be moving in a positive direction. But I still like to remain conservative. I like to be on the lower end than the high end. So right now the estimate that we had for 2015 was $1.5 million.
Yeah.
It looks like trending right now, we could end up at 1.520, but that's kind of just using run rates and not really knowing exactly what's going to happen in October, November, and December. So still comfortable with projecting $1.5 million for car registration fees in 2016. As we get closer to, we'll close the books and we'll know exactly how we ended up in 2015. That's something that we can take a look at and adjust as you get closer to setting your tax rate or closer to town meeting.
Okay.
I mean, that's your big revenue source, so
sure
it's something that I know that all selectmen budget committees all try to track very closely.
Trust me, I felt that registration fee this year.
Well, if you didn't buy a $120,000 truck.
No, I did not do that, but
you'd be half of that.
It's been 12 years since I owned a new vehicle, so I was reminded why I might not have had a new vehicle for so long.
Well, see, all these years you to save up, you were all set.
Building permits, we've already discussed. So no change in the fee system here, but just increased activity trying to capture that in a conservative estimate.
Yep.
Highway block grant. Based on information that we have right now, our best estimate is at $193,000. Again, hopefully this is conservative. Don't want to overestimate that.
If the state doesn't grab it.
It can be a target every now and then. And we also, so in our operating budget, I think you're all aware, saw it last meeting, we've budgeted 193 on the expense side. So it's a wash for road improvements.
So, all right, going down to the next one, income from departments. Why the drop?
1,000.
It looks like it's down in co-op various recyclables.
Oh, here we go, up here.
Because our costs are going up.
But
that lowers the revenue.
One of the things I learned on my tour today was that recycling facility is not getting the revenues that we used to get for our recyclables. And some of the recyclables are actually at the point where they've turned to be a cost to the town. So really, it sounds like to me, the only thing that that we're making revenue off from today is the aluminum cans and the scrap metal. The other things are really going up. Dave's very concerned about the increased costs for disposing of our electronic waste. Continues to go up on him. He's not getting any revenue that he used to receive for the plastics. And I guess even the paper and the glass bottles, some of those recyclables always had a cost, but the cost is now increasing for disposal. A lot of that, he said, had to deal with when the fuel prices drop. Sometimes that causes the plastics to actually, not a bit great demand for plastics. They'll use the raw oil to manufacture whatever it is they're producing. So I think that's primarily the concern here, and it's reflected in the budget.
But on that, the plastics are always good to recycle just because it takes volume away.
Well, of course, anytime we're recycling, even though it's a cost, I mean, you're taking it out of that the premium waste stream.
Exactly.
Of landfill costs and the incinerator cost.
Right,
so
right.
It's still a benefit to us to recycle. However,
the benefit has diminished.
It's starting to diminish. It is.
Yes. Okay.
And like I said, I'm not sure how the board wants to handle this. Revenue estimates aren't going to change a whole lot, but as we get closer and closer to December, we'll definitely be able to, I think we'll be able to project them at a fairly confident 95% confident rate.
Anybody have any questions or comments about the revenues budget?
Yeah, just one thing on the other miscellaneous revenues. It says Seymour restitution. I think, to be honest with you, there's really nothing more we're getting on that. I think that's done and over with.
I'm told we're actually receiving revenue still.
From where?
What's that?
From where?
We
were paid by insurance.
Well, from what my understanding is, there's the state of New Hampshire. We receive a check. It's a small amount. I think it might be on a quarterly basis. But we do receive small amounts of payment throughout the year.
Isn't he still in prison?
I guess this person is in prison and receives some compensation.
He's living in town.
What's that?
He's living in town.
Back at his old house?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, I can double check that then and see when's the last time we received.
$400, I don't think that the town will suffer irreparable damage if we don't
claim
it out. So, Mr. Chairman, I'll make a motion the Board of Selectmen approves a revenue estimate for 2016 of $2,310,773.
Second. I have a motion by Mr. Byron, second by Mr. Lemire. Any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? All those abstain? Motion carries 5-0-0. Next, we'll move on to personnel. Is this one ready?
Let's see here.
Yeah, this isn't usually ready till the end.
It's...
So you get your rates.
We've done our, well, that's the problem. You're not, the health insurance, so if you want to go through them, let's just talk through them. Health insurance, we don't have our rates yet, but you know that I've estimated them to increase 10%. That represents 10% of, for only 6 months, because our rates are good, as I understand, to July 1st.
Right.
So we renew July 1st. I'm estimating that for the remaining 6 months, those will increase 10%. I don't believe we're going to know what those new rates will be until after the first of the year. So short-term disability, those rates are going to be set mid-October. I've had Karen go through and work on the federal taxes. She's reworked the retirement. And you can see there's in the police, was it, or fire? The police department, we had a big increase. But again, she's worked the numbers twice. A lot of this is, you know, due to the wage increase. She's put a lot of time and effort into it. I think these numbers are fairly accurate. The wage plan implementation, as I understand, is we're budgeting $30,000. Be the same process as last year for implementation. So raises would be given on July 1st. I haven't really spoke too much. I don't know how it worked, but there's a lump sum money, sum of money that will be based on performance reviews.
Mm-hmm. Usually it's April 1st.
April 1st? Okay. This year the implementation was April 1st or
no.
July?
It was later.
It was later.
Yeah,
okay.
It was
so,
even later, wasn't it?
Probably.
All right.
But the reason April 1st is you're looking to see that the budget goes through.
Right.
I do have a question. You said, Troy, that the police have gone up because of the salary changes?
Well, it'll be, again, Karen went through, worked them, so it'd be wage increases, whatever wages were given last year. There was no increase.
So you're not calculating in any change right now into this budget for any potential contract change, right?
No.
Okay, thank you. That's all I wanted to make sure.
Yeah.
Well, speaking of, where are we with the contract negotiations?
As far as I know, it's not done yet. Anyways.
One thing I wanted to point out, the unemployment tax, based on correspondence we received from Primex, who's our unemployment provider, we're going to have, because of the holiday contribution, they don't actually send the town a check. They hold that contribution and they apply a credit towards future invoices, the premium costs. And we have such a large credit right now that there will be no cost next year. So I've put a dollar in the line just for a placeholder.
Okay.
And, we don't have property liability in here, right? No.
So
workers' comp rates will be set, again, mid-October.
So we need to hold off on a final approval on this anyway.
Yeah. But it's close.
Why not just send it through the way we have it, and we'll go back and amend it go from there?
Well, they'll see it anyway. They know it's not a vote on it. They'll just reference it, wouldn't they?
I don't know.
I don't know either. That's.
I thought they didn't want to reopen the lines.
Yeah, they made it.
Yeah.
And they made it clear. I thought they said it again last Thursday. They didn't want to have to go back and open up budgets.
I'm not sure they really know what they're going to do because we were missing some members.
Yeah. I think it's to our advantage not to adopt it. And so that when we have discussions with them, we can explain it's not adopted by the Board of Selectmen yet, pending
information. Mr. Chairman,
information.
Let's go on to the next budget.
Excellent. Let's do it. What was the next one? Town insurance. I don't think that one's going to get too far either.
Is that other insurances?
What budget
is it? So the tab is called other insurance, 4196.
You don't have those rates either, right?
No.
Okay.
But it does bring up a discussion that I don't know if we want to have it now, but you know, there's concerns that our current property liability insurance carrier may not be able to provide coverage next July. I have met with Primax. Primax just came by as a courtesy to, you know, introduce themselves, and we did discuss, you know, trying to put together a proposal where they would provide us with our, because they're currently providing unemployment and workers' compensation coverage, and if you end up having property liability through them, you can get this multi-policy discount. So, you know, I'm going to be working with them to get those numbers. But one of the decisions the board's going to need to make is, you know, whether or not we are going to work with Primax, where they are a risk pool for, you know, public sector here in the state of New Hampshire, or if you're going to want to also consider private insurance carriers, because it takes time to go out and get the quotes and evaluate them, and, you know, we don't know come July 1st if we're going to have coverage. And so this is an issue that's a lot of municipalities are very concerned about right now, and they're starting to get very active in working on, you know, getting quotes and plans in place. I throw that out there. It's going to be an agenda item, I think, here soon.
Yeah.
So we should leave this at this point.
Yes.
Okay.
So the only other budget that was on there was Parks and Recs, and they haven't had a meeting in a while.
Yeah, they're not meeting until next week, and I know they have a couple of warrant articles they want to bring forward. So I would say it's not ready.
Okay.
Are there any other budgets we got to review? Police, right?
Police is going to come in at our next meeting.
Fire?
Same with them. When was that you had them lined up to come in, Troy?
So that will be our next meeting, our next regular scheduled meeting, right?
The 26th?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I make a suggestion? We do ambulance. Now, I know that the chair made a suggestion that we needed to wait for Chief Frazel to come in for that, but I'm not sure that we do, because if there's no change in the contract, then...
I think there needs to be a new contract, doesn't there?
I don't know the answer to that. I know Troy and I discussed that. I don't know if he's found any answers out on that.
I also thought there was some considerations about something else too, so I think you should wait.
Yeah, I would rather, I'd feel much better if the chief was here when we did that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm okay with that too.
Are there any other budgets that we have other than that we haven't gone through?
Did we go through debt? I think we went through
debt. We did debt last time.
Yeah.
Can we raise debt?
To 2 months?
You could double it.
If you consider lease purchase, that, you know, it could be.
I think we did everything but library, the two major departments.
Cemeteries.
We did cemeteries. Didn't we?
Just for the record.
I think there was some confusion.
On the minutes?
Yeah.
On the last meeting?
Yeah. So, what was the first one? We just have two items in the meeting minutes of our last meeting where what Debbie had recorded and what we currently have in the proposed budget doesn't match. So the first one was accounting.
Yeah, the motion was for 215,354.
215,354.
Right, but now it's 215,117.
Or is it?
I have 123.
123 now.
Well, you changed it again.
The only change, I think it was the travel.
The only change that we recognized during the meeting was for the software cost. And I think we put in, where is it?
Your motion was for 215,354.
Right.
there was some problems, whoops, no, shit.
So, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to make a motion to reopen the accounting budget 4150.10.
I have a motion, do I have a second? I'll second it. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? All those abstain? We have now reopened the accounting budget.
So, currently right now, as in your proposed budget, the bottom line, $215,123. And I believe some minor changes were made to travel allowance, and I think there, is there a small software?
Yeah, it was $500. I don't think you captured the change, but...
Yeah. So it just, that amount is what's in the proposed budget. We're on record of what's the amount?
We're on record as $215,354.
$231 difference.
So is $215,123 a good number, Troy?
Yes.
Make a motion, Mr. Chairman, that the Board of Selectmen approve for a budget for accounting $215,123.
Second.
I have a motion and I have a second. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, we'll call us to vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 All those opposed, all those abstain. Motion carries 500. Deb, what was the other one that you had?
The other one was code enforcement. Your motion was for $78,500, but they've got $78,226 now.
Oh, that's... Yeah, but you know what? Because that's missing the that one's correct. It should be 78,500.
Okay.
It's missing the fire inspector certification.
Right. And it was speculated that the fire inspector certification was going to be like $169. I made the motion to increase it $274 because it wasn't felt the 169 was going to be sufficient. And that's where we came up with that number.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
78,500. 78,500.
Yeah.
So it stays
78,500. Yes. Well, it's 501 right now.
I know. So if I make it 274.
There you go.
That good?
There you go. That clears that up.
See, that column makes it so much easier for us to follow.
Okay.
There's no save button.
You don't have to save. It just happens. It's all magic.
It's alive.
Okay, so is that pretty well set? We're all set with budgets right now, and we're going to have the chiefs in at the next meeting. We still need to get a hold of the library and have them.
Yeah, October the 16th. I believe
you're meeting
I had
with
some
them.
Email. I won't be meeting with them. I don't believe, but they are meeting October 15th or 16th.
Have they been in touch with you yet about?
They have. We've not. The librarian went away on vacation soon after our meeting, so now we've just haven't connected since she's got back. But
okay.
So I was told through email that they'd be working on their budget October 15th or 16th. So. I don't know if that means they approve it that night or if they start work.
So open budgets are fire, PD, library, ambulance.
Parks and Rec.
Oh, here we go.
Parks and Rec, insurance.
Personnel.
Is that it?
I think so.
Yep.
Okay.
Emergency management.
Emergency management's going to be done with fire as well.
The chiefs.
Okay. Anybody have anything else about budgets before we move on?
The next meeting is going to be the 26th.
October 26th?
Yep.
So that'll get us sufficient. That'll keep us ahead of the needs of the budget committee, right?
Yep.
Will it?
I'm just why I'm asking the question.
They're only meeting once a week still, right?
Right.
The only thing we were missing out of the first two batches was the solid waste. And we have almost everything else done in the next batch even. And that carries us well beyond that next meeting. That was the way we saw it.
Well, you'll probably discuss about the revenues. The feedback we received, they wanted, you know, we'll still be meeting with we'll get more feedback, I'm sure, this Thursday, but they wanted a couple items moved up. One was revenues and...
Personnel.
And personnel. Yeah.
That's why I wanted to submit personnel, but...
Yeah. But, yeah.
Personnel is usually the last one they go down because of the rates don't come until October.
Who knows?
Well, like I said, if you give them the electronic link, they can go look at it. It'd be worthless to have a conversation about it until it's final.
Mm. Yeah.
I mean, I think you gave them a good heads up about, you know, the increases, where some of the major changes were going to be. It's really around personnel and insurance and some smaller dollar changes everyplace else. So.
Okay. So since we're done with that, we'll now move on to the next new business item, which would be Budget Committee alternate member.
I'm assuming because you're out for a week or two, right? Something like that.
I will be absent between the dates of 30th of October to the 17th of November. I'll be back on the 17th.
Who wants to sign on to handle the Budget Committee while Mr. Byron is unavailable?
See, I
which day is
Conservation the first Thursday, and then I have conflicts on Thursdays. Jesus. That's my problem.
Yep.
The last person I want to see walk in the room is me, so that's probably not a great idea.
I have a conflict every Thursday. I have a conflict every Tuesday. I have a conflict every other Monday.
Every other Kevin.
I have a conflict every Friday.
So I guess I'm it, huh? That's fine. I don't mind.
You said the 30th through when?
I am gone the 30th through the 17th.
So when is the meeting? When's the meeting? The 30th?
No, there's one every Thursday from here on out.
Yeah. Right.
So you would need to be able to attend
two.
The meeting on the 5th,
and the 12th.
Meeting on the 12th.
That's fine.
And Troy said...
It's possible the 12th could just be school. Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No.
You got to have a selectman's rep, yeah.
That's fine. That works. Gets me out of planning board, so.
November 5th and November 12th. You're going to jump on?
I'll jump on, yeah.
If there's any issue, I can cover too, so.
Yeah, it shouldn't be any issue. That should be fine.
Okay. How do we get that taken care of? New Hampshire assesses election ballot.
I'm not sure if this type of stuff has been brought to the board before, so I, you know, until I really learn what the board is interested in, this is kind of tough, but it's the Assessing Association. They're looking for, you know, municipalities to cast their votes. We could choose probably not to vote, or you could appoint me to fill out the ballot.
Are you familiar with any of the candidates on there?
You know, one or two. That's it. You know.
That's probably more than we are.
Yeah. So
that's 100% more than all.
Right. So, Mr. Chairman, I'll move that we designate the town administrator to cast the ballot.
I'll second that move.
I have a motion and I have a second. Is there any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed? All those abstain? Motion carries 5-0-0. Congratulations, Troy.
Thank you.
Vote once, vote often.
We're now into the administrator report. Troy?
All right.
It's your show.
This is, again, this is just informational purposes. The fire department held their annual fire truck parade this past Friday. They did it in the rain. Unfortunately, it really opened up right when they started.
Of course they did. All right. You're the shortest guy on the side of the road.
That's looking nice.
But the annual fire truck parade, as I understand, is a tradition in this town. It kicks off Fire Prevention Week, which is this week, October 4th through the 10th. So it's just a way for our fire department to increase awareness and make sure people are... it's that time of the year where you check your smoke detectors, the batteries in your smoke detectors.
Change the batteries.
Carbon monoxide detectors. Check those fire extinguishers and just make sure we have a good, safe winter.
And your family should have an evacuation plan for the home in case there's a fire.
Correct.
And just to touch on that real quick, I believe it's October 17th is open house for the fire department.
Oh.
That's, I was just going to ask that. Yeah. Usually have an open house. I mean,
I think it's the 17th.
Okay.
It's not
is
this
it Saturday
Sunday.
Or Sunday?
Sunday.
So that's, the, a, probably, that's the 18th.
So that's the 18th.
It's a Saturday. So I think it's the 17th. All right. Anyway, it's that weekend.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure it's that Saturday.
Excellent.
Okay, the next item is we received correspondence from Regional Economic Development Center of Southern New Hampshire, otherwise referred to as REDC. They apparently are reaching out to their territory, which I understand Litchfield's part of. They want to have a steering, or they have a steering committee. They're trying to get candidates for 2016. They're looking for nominees from, you know, that would represent private industry or businesses here in Litchfield. I bring this forward to the board. I'm not really familiar with this organization, and I'm not sure, you know, if we have a way of reaching out to our business businesses here in the community to see if they have, you know, any interest in having a representative. But I wanted to at least have it in the record that they've sent this correspondence.
And they're looking, as I read that, they're looking for a business person, right?
That's correct.
Mr. Chairman, can I make a nomination?
Sure.
Can I nominate Mr. Rennie Thoreau to serve as a representative?
Most certainly. I'll second that motion. Any
is he aware of this?
I was going to say, because
any discussion on this motion?
Is he aware of the?
Well, I think we should talk to him before we send it in. I mean, you don't nominate somebody if they don't want to be nominated, but I was thinking that he seemed to be active in the community. He's interested in the stuff, and I know that some other people who I could nominate are probably tied up in things where they wouldn't be able to do that. I can make another nomination if you want.
No, I'm totally supportive. I just was wondering if he was aware of it yet.
No, he's not aware of it. This is off the top of my head. That's why I'm saying that we ought to check with him before we send it in, that's all. Mm. That, you know, if we as a board are in favor of him as an individual to do that, then I think it makes sense that we ask him and approach him and see if he's willing to serve. If he is, then we send it in. If he's not, no harm, no foul.
I think it's a great idea. That is a motion, right? Mm-hmm. To nominate.
Let me close this.
Any other discussion? Hearing none, call us to a vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, all those abstain. Motion carries 5-0-0. Next. Okay, Dara Pond update?
Yes, so Selectmen Bork and myself attended the meeting a couple Fridays ago. We had representatives there from New Hampshire DES, town administrator and town engineer from town of Hudson, and Pinnacheck Waterworks had representatives there as well. The whole discussion was with about Dara Pond and the amount of water that's being used in that area that's being drawn out of the aquifer. I thought the purpose of the meeting was to be very informal, get the groups to the table, and get them just talking about the issues and concerns. I thought the meeting went really well. You can see the email correspondence we received from New Hampshire DES that just try to summarize some of the action items. There's no commitments here in any way. And I think the idea was that, you know, probably sometime after the first of the year, there'll be another meeting and a follow-up to try to keep this moving along. I'm sure you're all aware that a resident here in Litchfield has filed, as I understand, a lawsuit against the town of Hudson regarding the amount of water that they're pulling from the aquifer. And Hudson was, you know, obviously looking to see if there's anything they can do to try to help with this problem. Pinnacheck seemed to be willing to try to help out as much as they can, too. They volunteered to stop drawing at least 5,000 gallons per day from the pond.
Can I ask a question as to where that number came from? Because if they're drawing 800,000 gallons a day, 5,000 gallons
well,
is a pittance.
It was, you know, it was my first introduction to this issue in our town. But one of the things I learned was that there was a back
in 2000
there was a study that was done that town of Hudson paid for, and so we heard this number of 790,000 gallons per day was the report had stated was a safe amount to pull from the aquifer.
Right.
So somehow out of that 790,000, I guess Hudson pulls about 85% of that, and Pinnacheck pulls the other 15%. So I don't know where the 5,000 came from, but it was something that was thrown out there by Pinnacheck. So it, you know, it was thrown on the table, and there was some concern from New Hampshire DES with our high school that apparently they've you know, they have their irrigation system, and for some, I don't know how it happened, but they have sometimes exceeded the daily withdrawal limit, which is an exceedance of 20,000 gallons per day. When you're drawing that amount of water, apparently there's a permit that's required. But they've worked with the school, and you know, they believe that they're coming in under the 20,000 gallons. But they'd like to be able to install some metering equipment that Pinnacheck said that they would provide. If we could get the meter, radio control meter installed, Pinnacheck would when they go by and do their readings, they would read it on a monthly basis for no charge. I've not spoke to the high school about this at this point in time. The other things they wanted to do was install weather station just to monitor the amount of rainfall. And
would they be intending to adjust the withdrawal rate based upon rainfall and refreshing of the aquifer?
I think it was just they wanted to better understand the climate, the environment out there.
In this area. Because if you look at the summer, you know, there's been some good storms and stuff that virtually have gone around Litchfield.
I don't think we had an inch of rain in two months.
And that was it. You really can't base it on a station out in, we'll say, you know, Milford or Nashua or something like that. So that's why they talked about putting a station.
Yeah.
And they're talking about putting it on the high school roof. That way it could be solar powered. You know what I mean? And
yeah. Our irrigation system down at the Roy, was it Roy Memorial Park?
On Ella Craig?
No, Darrell Pond Park.
Darrell Pond.
We need to make sure, we installed some equipment this year, I'm not sure if it's fully operating the way it should be. So we need to make sure we get it up and running properly next year, so we're documenting our usage. In fact, I met with the contractor that we use that over, you know, cuts the grass and I guess uses the irrigation system for the rec department. Met them this morning, just when I was down checking out Sawmill, or Sawbrook Park. And he even mentioned that there was some, you know, some problems with the irrigation system down there, that just more security, less people involved in touching buttons and changing the programming, so. Anyhow, that's, you know, some of the, that was kind of a overall discussion of how it went. Like I said, I think there'll be a follow-up meeting. It's, all this, again, is informal. It's my understanding that, as you saw in the email, that the governor had asked New Hampshire DES to intervene and bring these parties to the table to start having informal discussions.
Was there any discussion whatsoever concerning the monitoring wells that were installed at Darrell Park, or Roy Memorial Park, as we call it?
Sorry.
Can't recall. He talked about the wells, but yeah. I don't know if it was specific to Dara.
There are about four or five wells that are in there, not that are used for water, providing water, but are used for monitoring the water, groundwater levels. And those were being monitored on with some periodicity, and I don't know what's happened to that.
Yeah, no.
And are they owned by Hudson?
They were put in by Hudson.
Hudson, okay.
And Penichuk, I think, was sending people around to do readings on them.
Okay.
I'm just glad to see in the sum of this whole evaluation going on that we're most worried about the school maybe watering that lawn a little too much, and we're going to evaluate by possibly dropping 5,000 gallons worth of draw. But we're not going to worry about the 800,000 we already take.
Not us, Hudson.
Yeah, exactly. The point is, I hate to say it, but this almost seems like a big, giant waste of time.
Mm.
Because it's not getting anywhere to solve the problem. And the problem is that the level in Dara keeps going down, and everybody puts their hands in the air and say, it's not us, it's them.
Yeah.
They're pointing at us as a town.
Right. But I think, to be honest with you, when I went into the meeting, and Kevin was there, and you can, you know, see if you agree with me or not, but I was expecting the fingers to be pointed at the town and the school because of some information I had heard prior to going into the meeting. I think Penichuk and the town of Hudson were very concerned about this issue. And I think as long as the town and the school and, you know, we document our usage, we have a right to the use of that aquifer, and as long as we don't exceed the 20,000 gallons per day, we have a right for that usage. So I think if anything escalates in the future, I do think that a lot more pressure is going to be put on Penichuk in the town of Hudson.
The bottom line on it is
they want to throw the bombs at us and saying, well, we're just pumping, you know, millions of gallons a day to keep our green football field and soccer field, you know. But
that was the exact same strategy that was used back in 2002, 2003, or whatever it was, when this whole thing came up before. The point is that Penichuk has considered constructing underneath the Merrimack River an additional line to feed Litchfield. And once that line goes in, water prices in Litchfield should drop.
They talked about that inside the meeting, and they just said it wasn't cost.
Wasn't going to happen.
It ain't going to happen.
Well, last time I had a meeting with the COO of Penichuk.
Well, he was there in our meeting, wasn't he?
Don Ware?
Yeah, he was there.
Okay, because he would come right out and say
it's not cost effective. You know what I mean? It would actually cost us more for water if they actually ran that pipeline, is what he said.
That's not what he told me. I believe everything you said. I'm just wondering what changed.
Yeah, I don't know. That's what he told us on the meeting.
He did. Yeah.
Sounds like they don't want to do it.
And I think it was Kevin. Kevin mentioned something about possibly teaming up with Manchester as well, running a water line from Manchester or something, right? And he said the same thing with that. It would actually cost us more.
Well, I remember years and years ago when I was on the planning board, and Penichuk came in, and it was Mr. Ware that came in, to discuss the water usage in town and how to expand the capability at the south end by bringing lines up. And they said with the lines down in the southern or the northern tier of Hudson were too small. He says, and the amount of money it would cost to upgrade those lines to increase your lines here won't happen. We're not going to pay that bill. So it goes to tell you. Now, since then, I know some of those new developments that went in, they have increased some of the lines, but it's not that it's come to our border yet. So it seems like Penichuk doesn't like to front the money. That's where the real problem comes. That's just my assumption.
I do agree with what you were saying. I don't think they were really pointing the fingers at us. They were just saying some of the things that we could correct to try and cut down some of the water usage is all they were virtually saying.
And I just think it's good for the town if we have our data. If one day they really start to point their finger, then we will have our documentation to explain exactly how many gallons we use for irrigation.
Yeah, but we got to get this information to the school. We need to get this information to the school.
Yes. Yeah. I think Kevin's working with the school, right?
He is. I've got a couple of things I got to meet with the business administrator with, so this would be one of the items I want to talk to him about.
Anyway.
It's just crazy to me. Even if we draw 25,000 gallons to water football fields, it's nowhere near 800,000 that's being pulled.
No.
It's always so easy to go after the town. It really is.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, absolutely right.
So, okay. Next item.
Okay. The next item was just informational purposes. Some of you are probably aware the Department of Transportation, they've come out with their 10-year improvement plan. Town of Litchfield, from my review of the plan and discussions with the Natural Regional Planning Commission, we don't have any projects listed in the plan. So, but there are public hearings coming up, and I'm not sure if I just wanted it on the record that, you know, that is my understanding we're not in the plan. I don't know if there's been projects that you've been discussing over the last few years.
No, I don't think there's anything in here. I'm up to page 107.
Well, I saw there was nothing for Litchfield.
Yeah.
It would be nice if they fixed Hillcrest, but I won't tell you.
Well,
but that doesn't go in the 10-year plan, John.
Doesn't go.
That's under another part of their
budget. Oh, I thought I saw some road projects in there too. That's why I just
yeah. Hillcrest isn't in there, but when I was talking with the NRPC today, and they informed me that included in the plan there is sort of like a lump sum dollar amount that's allocated statewide,
right,
for resurfacing, just general paving. It's not earmarked for any specific projects. Once approved, all the districts get together and somehow, you know, through politics and whatever, they divvy up the money. So that's when I was talking to Jack today about Hillcrest, just trying to understand what, you know, the condition that Hillcrest is in. I travel that every day. I know it's not in great condition.
It was made worse the last time they resurfaced.
They did a shim and overlay, or just a shim.
It was better before they touched it.
Yeah.
I ride on a motorcycle. Trust me, I know.
So I'm not sure the history.
$1,000 truck on it instead.
But
I had to get over it.
Are you aware that if the board's actually sent any correspondence? I'm sure
I wasn't on the board when it happened.
I think we sent something when they did the shim.
Okay.
If I remember, but do you remember, Frank?
It might be time. It might be good timing that we remind them that when they did the shim job, that's usually a temporary measure until they have funding secured for the shim and overlay.
They weren't going to redo the center lines or the fog lines, and I know a citizen in town gave the money to the town to do it because they wouldn't do it. I'm trying, I wonder if I'm confusing the two issues. I know we wrote a letter.
I think it was because of the lines.
Yeah, I think we wrote a letter to either because of the road being redone or because of the letters. I have to go back in the minutes and find it, but.
Well, I know right up here, as the road bends, there's a driveway that comes down into the road. And as soon as the ice starts to happen, the sheeting that comes down from the driveway and the way they basically ruin the road, there's a giant puddle at the bottom of that person's driveway that just turns into a sheet of ice. Last year, it was like that for probably 2 months straight. And when you look, you can see that sections of the road, sections of the shim, have shifted off the road.
Yeah, I'm sure.
That's how you know when at the right location. Yeah. It's just, they did a job on
it. It's in poor shape. And, you know, I mean, you could say, yeah, I'd like to have you pave it, but, you know, that will be good for 5 years. But, yeah, I think the project is more of a rebuild with drainage, you know.
How about if we ask Troy to contact the Bedford, Division 5 in Bedford and see what their plans are, if any.
It's not a bad idea.
While you're at it, ask them if they're going to do anything in Hudson for the intersection of Page Road and 102.
That, as I understand, would be something that would be in this, but let's see.
House Finance does not put into the budget anything that would go down to the level of detail on roads other than maybe for bigger projects like
right.
93. Mm. Work on 89 or something like that.
Okay. All right, good. Well, I'll investigate the Hillcrest and the intersection of Page and 102. And where are we now?
So now we're on this
NRPC transit. Okay. Again, correspondence sent to the board. This is, again, informational purposes. National Regional Planning Commission will be starting an initiative where they're going to be taking a look at the regional transportation system in our area. They've put us on notice that they will be reaching out to the town of Litchfield, its residents. Not sure how they plan on doing that, but I just wanted to make sure the board was aware of this. The NRPC is about to undertake this project. Town administrator report. I believe that concludes my report.
Excellent. So moving on, selectmen reports. Do any selectmen have any reports?
Budget committee met last Thursday. Troy and I attended. We provided them the budgets that we had gotten done the meeting of September 28th or whatever it was. And other than that, the only thing is I explained to them the procedure for getting advice of counsel. And that was it. There was some misunderstanding, apparently, of how that worked.
You explained it exactly the same way we explained it last year.
I understand that, but.
Okay. Any other selectmen reports?
Mr. Chairman, Conservation had to move their meeting from the 1st to this coming Thursday, and I will be unable to attend. I just wondered if there was anybody that could attend.
I can't because I got my daughter's rehearsal Thursday night for.
I told them there may not be, but I would ask anyway.
Otherwise, I would have. I would.
On Thursday?
Yeah.
This Thursday, the 8th?
Yes.
I have a budget committee meeting.
Right. Okay. All right, I'll tell them, and they're pretty good. They keep me posted on activities, so I'll follow up.
But Kevin was raising his. I saw Kevin raise his hand.
And Kevin, if there is any conflict, let me know. I can. Those I get those.
There shouldn't be any.
I can do
it. Should be fine.
Thursdays, I think.
Okay. Any other selectmen reports? There are none. Items moved from consent. We don't have any other business. Want to go first? Want me to go first? You already did. So it's me. Planning board coverage. It's a planning board meeting tomorrow night. I can tell you, I can't go to a planning board meeting for probably another 2 months.
Who's on the planning board? You?
Me?
Yeah, I thought so, okay.
Because when we were divvying these things up, I told you Tuesdays were bad for me and Tuesdays would be even worse for me later on. Well, this is later on. So I am not going to be able to make a planning board meeting at least until Thanksgiving. So I don't know if anybody can sign on to taking on Tuesdays at planning until then. And then at that point, I should be freed up. But
how often do they meet?
It's two Tuesdays a month, and tomorrow is their meeting. So that would be...
I can't do tomorrow, but I could probably do the next one.
As I say, I can't do tomorrow, but I can fill in also if somebody can't.
I can probably do tomorrow. I just, planning's not my specialty.
I'm right with you.
We're all in that boat.
But the only requirement to serve on the planning board is a pocket protector and an engineering role. And
well, I have both, but that doesn't mean I'm an engineer.
Then you're a natural.
I can do tomorrow night. I don't see any reason why I can't do tomorrow night.
Okay.
And I can do the next one.
And then I might be able to do the one after that if you want.
Which is?
Sean's going to do October 6th.
I'll do the 20th.
And that's at 7, right?
It's at 7, yes. October 20th will be Kevin.
And then we can talk about it after.
And then we can work on November right. From there. Thank you very much, guys. I'll let them know of those changes. Yes, Troy.
Just for clarification, I think we spoke about this earlier this evening. Our next meeting, the one that I set up with the two chiefs, would be the 19th. So.
Okay, so we went 2 weeks from today.
Yeah, so next Monday would be Columbus Day, and the following one, the 19th, is when we would meet with the chiefs, and that keeps us on schedule for... you know, meeting with budget committee.
Okay.
That's not our usual.
It's not.
No.
So
would we then change and cancel the meeting on the 26th?
I would say we could.
Yeah.
Or hold it just in case.
Yeah, we could hold it for now and see.
Yeah.
All right. So we're doing the 19th? The 19th? Yes.
So on the 19th,
October 19th,
I may be late, but I'll be here.
Okay.
I have a standing meeting in Boston, so that's why. That week drives me crazy, but yeah, I'll be here. I'll just be like maybe a few minutes late.
Okay.
So, and we're starting at 6?
Yes. So for those at home, just for clarification, the selectmen will meet next on October 19th at 6 o'clock. So for this month, we've basically deviated from our schedule from what, 2nd and 4th to... First and third. And we are likely to go back to our normal schedule in November. Just to be clear.
Okay.
So everybody's good for Monday, October 8th, 19th, except John may be a few minutes late.
Good.
Yep.
Perfect.
And we are, and you just said we're canceling the 26th.
We are canceling the 26th. Okay. Well, we're going to hold it for now.
Hold it, yeah.
It's budget season, you know. You never know.
If something comes up between now and the 19th that we decide we need to do the 26th, we will.
Okay.
But if that doesn't happen, yeah, we'll probably. Okay. So other than that, is there any other business anybody has to bring to the board? Hearing none, we do not need to go into the non-public session that we had scheduled. Correct, Troy?
That's correct.
Okay, so from that, it looks like we're done for the night. Do I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved, Mr.
Second.
I have a motion and a second to adjourn. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? All those abstain? Motion carries 5-0-0. So we are adjourned at 7:40. Again, please note that our next meeting will be October 19th. It will not be next week, and it will not be the week of the 26th. So, we will see you again on October 19th.
Fire Prevention Weeks this week. The fire open house
17th.
Is probably the 17th. It's that weekend. And don't forget to change the batteries and your smoke detectors and your carbon monoxide. Have a good night.